We're going to talk about the three C's. And I'm going to begin by just mentioning all three of them. But I think they're so important: commitment, consistency, and control, that we're going to spend three meetings. Tonight's commitment, next week's consistency, and the week after's control. Somebody said to me tonight that they're doing very well. They did great, then they had some rough spots, and now they're doing very well again. And she said to me, "I really think it's all in my head. It's all in my head." Now, studies say that weight loss is 80% mental. But you know what? I disagree with that. I think it's 100% mental. 100. Because when your head's in it, you don't need anything else. You can say no to the pizza. You can say I'm going to get off my duff and move a little bit. So we're going to talk about the fact that the commitment isn't just to the healthy lifestyle. The commitment is to yourself. Your kids are always going to be having issues. Remind me after the camera, I'll tell you something funny about my mother. The kids are always going to have something, whether they're 10, whether they're a baby, or when they're 50. They're always going to have something. You're going to have trouble with your job. You're going to have trouble here, there. When is there going to be time for yourself? This is a commitment to yourself. It's a commitment to say, I am going to do this, and I'm going to keep the weight off. Especially, let's say you're maintaining your weight loss and you want to have a piece of bacon. Or you say, on Friday I'll have some pizza. You're maintaining. But many people who haven't even begun to start to lose weight are just dabbling. They're having BLTs. They're having fried fish. They're having fries. And they're looking at me like, you're telling me I can't have these things? I'm telling you that if you make a commitment to a healthy lifestyle, that isn't on that healthy lifestyle plan. I'm not telling you, you can have anything you want, but is it part of a healthy lifestyle? And what you have to say to yourself is why you want to change your life. That is the second thing. It's all here, and part of that thing here is the why. I want to not have knee surgery. I want to not have high blood pressure or high cholesterol. I want to get off some of my medications. I want to live to see my grandchildren. I want to just fit in my clothes better. The whys are important, but then you have to commit to the whys. And it will be I'm ready to say it, listen, sacrifice. Nothing happens in this world without a sacrifice. You have to say, you know what? Maybe if I'm laying there in bed, a piece of pizza, it tastes darn good. I'm sure it would. I'm sure it would be great. But you say, no, it's a sacrifice. One of the things that helped me is when I remembered the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross, and I would think, I can't sacrifice a donut when Jesus sacrificed his life for me. We're a religious pray-it-off group. We believe in the resurrection. Let's think about that when we're making a commitment to our healthy lifestyle. Without respecting yourself and your commitment, others will not have respect for you or your attempts to lose weight and change your life. You don't think after 5 years of doing this, people know? As a matter of fact, somebody where I work needed help picking a healthy menu, one of the residents. And somebody in dietary said, maybe she'll listen to you. And we had a wonderful chat because they knew I had a commitment. You don't have to be skinny. I'm not a rail, but I've made a commitment to a healthy lifestyle. Okay, so I talked to you about the mental commitment. And you know what else I find? A lot of people are spectator commitments. Like they're watching The Biggest Loser eating a bag of chips. Oh man, look at those people. You know, wow, look how fat they are. Or they're reading the magazines. You know, you go out in the checkout or price shopper, how to lose 50 pounds in 1 minute. You know, maybe I'll get that one. You know, or everywhere you look, there's the magazines. And you're a spectator. You come here once a week and you say, I'm going to a weight loss group. It's like having that gym membership and never going. You have to commit to participate. I don't watch The Biggest Loser because I feel, and I'm not doubting them. I'm sure there's some credence to what they're doing, but I think you have to make a commitment to lead your regular life. No one's taking me to any ranch. Is anyone going to the ranch next week to work with Jillian? Not me. I mean, I have to get up and get dressed and go to work and come home. I think it's all got to be real life. That's why I don't go for the fake foods, the alleys, the this, that. Real things, real food, real life. And real life, as we all have said many times, can suck sometimes. You give up. One person came up, they want to tell me something tonight. I go, you're not going to quit, are you? Because I'm not going to let you. You know, I'm paranoid. I don't want people to quit because we give up on ourselves. And then what? Then what? It's also a long period of time. This commitment, I make people commit to a six-month initial program. But do I think 6 months is enough? I don't. I think 6 months you get a taste of it. And then you say, you know what, I'm going to work on it maybe. Does the Bible say, go to church every Sunday for 6 months, and then you're done? No, you go once a week, you get that fired up, you know, that's what you're going for. To get fired up with God, to remind yourself in your busy life that God is there and God loves you. The same thing with pray it off. And here's one word that if you don't have, or maybe I should say, to be polite, I should say three words that I think everyone really needs to learn. And it's something that Catherine said tonight. And if you need to, write these down. These are the three words that will help you lose weight. Are you ready, everybody? No, thank you. No, thank you. You could just say no, but I'm kind of a polite person, so I would say no, thank you. And then you say it, and you say it, and you say it. And you sometimes have to say it to yourself. Who's offering you those chips at night when you live by yourself in your home? My question to you is, why are they there? Don't bring up grandchildren. I don't want to hear about your grandchildren. Ever bring their own chips. Ever bring their own chips. That's what they do. Oh, I got grandchildren. I don't care. They got chips themselves. So, and then somebody said, somebody brought, you know, one person, somebody sent them a basket full of the most fattening things you'd ever want to see in their life. They didn't know what to do with it. They brought it here and gave it to me, and I have given something to every thin person I know. Here, have these chocolate-covered almonds or whatever was in that basket. You don't know what to do with fattening things, and you don't want to throw it away, give it away. Okay, I'm going to stop right there, Bobby.